Assalamualaikum. Welcome to Supply Chain Talks. Today is the 9th episode of the 10-part series of purchase process. So far in the purchase process, we have looked at need recognition, need definition, supply source, price analysis, purchase, follow-up, and receipt. Today we are going to talk about the 8th step of the purchase process, which is payment. Effectively, this is the last step of the purchase process. All organizations have to do the payment for the material or services that they have acquired from the supplier or service provider against the invoice that is submitted as per the payment terms in the purchase order. Over the years, I've experienced that most of the time, the invoice is directly forwarded to the accounts department by the purchase without checking them, or the supplier directly submits the invoice to the accounts department. Now, there's always a difference of opinion who is responsible for the checking of the invoice. Based on experience, it is the responsibility of both the purchase and the accounts department. My perspective is that the purchase has to perform the initial check of the invoice as they are the owners of the process. Any discrepancy in the invoice can be checked in advance by the purchase so that at the time of the invoice payment or when the invoice is due, there should not be any delay. If the invoice is directly submitted to the accounts, what will usually happen is that accounts would only look at the invoice and check its validity or its correctness at the time of the payment of the invoice as per the payment terms. Now, if there is any discrepancy or any error in the invoice, accounts will simply reject it and send back to the vendor. As the invoice was already due and now the error or discrepancy has been identified, this would further delay the invoice payment process, and this usually becomes a topic of discomfort or discord between the supplier and the buyer. And this has a negative impact on the supplier relationship. Thus, in order to ensure that the supplier relationship is intact, the purchase should review the invoice when they receive it, and only after checking it should forward it to the accounts department. Now, what are the points that the purchase has to check in the invoice? Let's have a look at them. Invoice should have the PO number and the packing list reference mentioned on it. Quantity mentioned on the invoice should be the same as the goods physically received. Price, payment terms, and conditions on the invoice should match that on the purchase order. Description of the goods should be the same as that on the purchase order. If there is any error, then the supplier should be immediately contacted for rectification so that they submit the invoice after the rectification and the purchase process is continued without any delays or hindrance. This brings to conclusion our discussion on the step 8 of the purchase process, that is payment. If you have any questions or queries, please leave them in the comment below and I will get back to them at the soonest. Thank you for watching, and do remember to subscribe to the channel. Thank you.